have one announcement before we begin. We've mentioned John McPherson, who has been battling COVID for a number of weeks and been in the hospital. He is better, and they're thinking that he may get to go home tomorrow. His wife joined us this afternoon, so appreciate your prayers on his behalf. Now, number 232.
Look at Psalm 62 this evening. Psalm 62. Truly my soul silently waits for God. From him comes my salvation. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved. How long will you attack me? How long will you attack a man? You shall be slain, all of you, like a leaning wall and a tottering fence. They only consult to cast him down from his high position. They delight in lies. They bless with their mouth, but they curse inwardly. My soul waits silently for God alone, for my expectation is from him. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory, the rock of my strength, and my refuge is in God. Trust in him at all times, you people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us. Salah. Surely men of low degree are a vapor, men of high degree are a lie. If they are weighed on scales, they are altogether lighter than the vapor. Do not trust in oppression, nor vainly hope in robbery. If riches increase, do not sell your heart on them. God has spoken once, twice I have heard this. That power belongs to God, also to you, O Lord, belongs mercy, for you render to each one according to his work. This time we'll go to Heavenly Father, pray.
Father, have thank you so much for the wonderful privilege that you've given us to assemble ourselves together with the saints to worship you and to remember your Son Jesus and to sing these songs of praise, honor, and glory in this hour. Father, we're so thankful for your word and for the reading of it. Father, we know that it's powerful and it won't return to you without accomplishing its goal. Father, we thank you so much for your great love and for your grace and your mercy, and your patience with us, and for your Son Jesus who died upon the cross for us. Please help us to be imitators of him, and please forgive us of our sins, and please strengthen us because we're so weak and sinful. Father, we thank you so much for your Holy Spirit who dwells within us and gives us gifts and leads us and guides us. Guard us and protect us. Father, we thank you so much for allowing us to be members of your church. We thank you so much for this congregation of your people. And Father, we pray your continued blessings on your church and on us here. And Father, we ask that you would especially bless those that have the rule and authority over us here, the elders, that they might lead in such a way that you would be pleased and that we'll all be better people and that we'll each all have a home in heaven with you when this life is over. Father, mindful of those that are sick at this number, those that are shut in, those that are elderly, those that have had surgeries, and those that have recently lost loved ones. Father, we ask your healing hand upon each and every one of them. Father, we are so mindful of our nation and for the sinfulness of it. Father, please help us as citizens of this nation that we might put away evil far, far away from us. And Father, please help those that are in leadership positions to know that they're to be ministers of righteousness for you and that you won't stand for evil. Father, we ask that you would guide us through this song service to thee. Help us to sing with the understanding and with the melody in our heart. And may these songs come up to you beneficial to us, but also, Father, we pray that they'll be in spirit and in truth. Father, we pray that you would please guide our heart and be with us in all that we do. And Father, we pray that all that we do is for thee. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Happiness is the Lord.
Through joy is
I pitch that too high, what happens, you don't get pitched by it.
Which about this little pitch?
That's the whole boy that's going. Can't be higher than what's on the go. Let's blow me a G.
A G.
Well, now let's go in with an F sharp. An F sharp. Lower half step.
Happiness is to know the Savior, living a life within His favor, having a change in my behavior. Happiness is the Lord. Happiness is a new creation, Jesus and me in close relation.
I was not on the journey up to Golgotha's hill, nor was I in the garden the night when time stood still. I did not sell the Savior unto the angry crowd, nor hear the words as silent, denied the Lord aloud. I did not see the lightning as it flashed on that sad day, nor have the water Mary place spices where He lay. I lived my life much later, and in a different land, but as I stood, I cried again, a nail into His hand. I know my Savior loves me, He gave His life so free. Upon the cross of Calvary, He died for you and me. Let's live our lives for Jesus. Don't crucify again. Give praise and honor to the Lord and hold His nail scar.
Lord, we show me every Number 420 in the big book. 420.
Oh, thou fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy praise. Springs of mercy, never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise.
Jesus, he's everything to me. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. The lily of the valley, in him alone I see. All I need to cleanse and make me fully whole. In sorrow he's my comfort, in trouble he's my safe. He tells me every care on him to roll. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. He will never, never leave me, nor yet forsake me here, while I live by faith and do his blessed will. A wall of fire about me, I've nothing now to fear. With his manna he my hungry soul shall fill. Then sweeping up to glory, to see his blessed face, where rivers of delight shall ever roll. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul.
Oh.
This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home. Walking alone at evening, viewing the skies afar, bidding the darkness come to welcome each silver star. I had a great delight in the wonderful scenes above. God in His power and might is showing His truth and love. Oh, for a home with God, a place
you have enjoyed putting our voices together and singing praises to God. I know I sure have this evening. And just for a moment, just want to have to make a few comments, and then we'll offer the invitation. But not too long ago, Mary and I, and we were, and a few of us, we were at a restaurant, and Mary ordered she wanted some fried pickles. And so the lady left, and they brought her food out, and still no fried pickles. And they said, I think Leather Lady said, well, she ordered some fried pickles. And she said, okay. And she came back, and she laid a plate with one dill pickle spear on the plate. Well, I couldn't help. I just got so ticked. I started laughing. I was like, you know, she's ordered something, and she can't even get what she's ordered. And it was kind of complicated. She just said, never mind. We've already eaten our food and stuff. But you know, when God promises something, we can be assured. We can be assured that He's not going to forget us, and that He's going to give us what He's promised. We mentioned this verse this morning, but in Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 23, let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for He is faithful that promised. God can be trusted to keep His promise. He's promised eternal life to those that are His, to those that walk with His Son, and that's indeed what will happen when we live a faithful life. We turn into 2 Peter chapter 1. In 2 Peter chapter 1, we see in verse 4, it says, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. We can turn back to 1 Peter chapter 1. We're starting in verse 3 when he says, blessed be the Lord, as we be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to His abundant mercy hath begotten us again into a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. To what? To an inheritance that is incorruptible, that is undefiled, that fades not away, that is reserved in heaven for you. He says there is a reservation for you. He will not forget it. And He will not change His mind. He's created it for us. And that's why we can sing that song. And we can sing a song number 360. We can sing that standing on the promises. Standing on the promises of Christ my King through eternal ages. Let His praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises that cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear assail. By the living word of God, I shall prevail, standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of Christ the Lord, bound to Him eternally by love's strong cord. Overcoming daily with the Savior's sword. Standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. We can have full assurance that when this life is over, that heaven will be our home. If we will use this word, and we will live this word, and we will obey Him in spirit and in truth all the days of our life, we can be rest assured that heaven will be our home. Tonight, there might be some in the audience that they're not Christians. What promises are you standing on? He's given a great promise. He's given us His Son. Once you become a Christian tonight, if there's something that is amiss in your life and you need to get that right too, won't you come forward as we sing the invitation song.
Jesus the Lord in church.